It's Brooke and Jeffrey in the morning, and there hasn't been a more difficult time in the history of the world for randos to get together and hook up.
Oh, for real?
Honestly.
Dude, one of my girls just met someone on Match, and I'm like, how?
Yeah.
Yeah, what are you gonna do?
Yeah.
And more or less talking about dating. You guys remember dating?
Not really.
Most people. Is that the one where you drive around and look at dudes through their bathroom window?
Oh.
Is that dating?
Don't repeat that.
That's
maybe
another type of eating. Okay. Yeah, not that.
All right. I mean, just look at our show. Like, we have Alexis, who's a cute, fairly educated young person. And her dating life is drier than the Sahara Desert during a drought.
Yeah. Thanks for that one.
I'm just kind of, you know, not lying. And as you know, it's not just the singles who are realizing this. Major companies are seeing it too.
Yeah, because they always want to cash in on people's loneliness.
Well, it's a problem for them because if people aren't dating and getting married and having babies, that's going to affect their bottom line.
Oh, good point. Okay.
And a few businesses realize this, and they're stepping up to try and find creative solutions to help the singles get together.
All right.
For example, the dating app Hinge. They've teamed up with Chipotle and Uber Eats recently to encourage their users to dine together while having a distance date.
Oh, I love that idea where, like, you're doing a virtual date and you both get the same. Like, it's like you're ordering from a restaurant.
Yeah.
And to help set the mood, the app gives you a prompt that says, I'll bring the burritos if you bring ..
Okay. Ooh. I mean, tacos.
Yeah, you can fill in whatever favorite go-to Chipotle item is.
Brooke, you sound boring to date. Like, he's already bringing Mexican food. Brooke's like, more burritos.
Yeah.
Was that a euphemism that you were trying to throw in there?
Never.
Okay. Well, the whole idea is you see what each other says and then you match. Well, if it goes well and you do decide to meet up, Hinge and Chipotle even made a special cuffing season menu that you can order off of for your date.
I actually like this.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I'm glad it's those two.
Yeah.
And here's the interesting part, though. Their cuffing menu includes something called the Hinge Date, which is described as one entree, chips and salsa, and one soda to share.
What?
But how are you sharing?
Yeah, I don't know.
So, did they read an article where they thought girls really did eat salad only or something? Like, what's going on?
One meal to split during a pandemic? I don't know. It's a bold strategy.
I realize money's tight, people, but like.
Plus, 10 customers who order off the cuffing season menu are going to get dating advice from actress Rebel Wilson.
Okay.
Oh.
She's doing good. She's had a year of health. She is on her best game right now.
Yeah.
Really?
It's an interesting choice.
I mean, I
know if I'm single, I definitely want to hear dating advice from a never married 38-year-old comedian. That's where I'm going first.
Such a good point.
But, you know, that's not the only business that's stepping up to help singles find love.
Okay.
Because Airbnb just announced it's partnering with Bumble to give newly matched couples not a regular old Zoom date, but a special international virtual dating experience.
Don't tell me you're just going to give me a 3D video tour of some cool place in France that I can't go to.
Oh, okay. That's not good enough for you?
Well, she's probably
If I can't
there.
Go there, it sucks.
No one can.
I know.
I only take real trips to France. Don't show me pictures like a poor person.
It just gets sad.
Okay.
Is that sadder than just sitting in your house zooming them?
Yeah,
I guess.
You've already been
maybe
there,
not.
Remember your memories. Okay?
Let me tell you how this works, okay? The idea is, after you match with someone on the app, you book a virtual date through the Airbnb website where two people can share an experience together at different locations around the world.
So, like, you're at the Eiffel Tower together virtually, and you're like, oh, look at the sights.
No, it's not like that, no.
Oh.
So, for example, you can reserve a Turkish fortune coffee reading from a place in New York City.
Okay, that's actually cool.
So you and your date, you're both going to be on Zoom, and then some guy from a Turkish coffee shop in New York hops onto your call.
What?
So it's like you're both on a date at the coffee shop.
That is actually pretty sweet.
And the guy will take your coffee order, he'll tell you what your fortunes are after he reads them out of the cup, and he'll even spill some coffee on himself and accuse you of doing it.
Oh my God.
It could help with the awkwardness.
Yeah, so, you need somebody else. You need some other energy in a Zoom date. That's the problem,
It's
right?
like they're giving you an activity to do together on Zoom.
I love it.
Some of the other virtual dates that you can book include a couple's tarot reading with Mick Jagger.
Ooh, Mick Jagger?
Mick Jagger?
Yeah, not Mick Jagger.
Oh!
Mack Jagger.
Is that his, like, stepbrother or something?
Apparently, it's this female psychic reader from Austin, Texas.
Okay.
Oh, that
sounds
fun.
Yeah, and she'll read your tarot cards for you with
I
your
bet
date.
Our old front desk secretary will do it for you for a lot cheaper, I bet.
Oh, yeah.
Probably.
Yeah.
You can also play with the woolly sheep on a New Zealand farm.
How do you play with them?
Yeah.
I guess you just talk to them through like a cell phone.
Sit. Look, I got it to sit.
I want to rub its belly.
They also have a date called All About Coffee with a Pro Taster, and that's with somebody who lives in Bogota, Colombia, on a coffee farm.
That's kind of cool.
I guess.
Coffee.
Maybe they just like drink coffees on the call and they're like, this one tastes like hazelnut.
And you don't speak Spanish, so you have no idea what's going on.
Yeah, I'm not really sure how that one works, but at least they're giving you experiences to have together rather than just talking for a while.
See, I would even do some of these for date nights with my husband, too.
Oh.
I don't know.
No. I mean,
it's weird that you would hop on a Zoom call with your husband that you live with.
Well, we would be together and then we just bring that coffee dude in. No?
Wow.
Don't take away from the single.
I'm just trying to say this is for
there's
everyone.
There's other websites if you want to invite people into your relationship, Brooke, okay? So lots of companies are trying to work together to help lonely people find love during the lockdown. I wonder who's going to step up next.
Mm. Yeah.
I heard that Tinder's thinking of partnering with Motel 6.
Just to get to the
just
business.
Giving discounts for the one night.
That nice. Makes sense. It really does.
But if you have some ideas for companies that you think should partner up, text them in to 78592. We've got your phone tab coming up. Right.